Hey everyone, Dr.Mungli here. In this video, I will be explaining you about alcohol metabolism, that is ethanol metabolism. When a person takes alcohol, around 5% of the alcohol is absorbed in the mouth and in the esophagus and in the stomach, and 95% of the alcohol which is reaching portal circulation. So from the portal circulation, it will be reaching liver. Liver is the major organ where alcohol is metabolized in our body. Around 85 to 95% of alcohol in the liver is metabolized by enzyme mediated action, and that is ethanol is converted to acetaldehyde, and acetaldehyde is converted to acetate, and acetate further converted into acetyl CoA. All this conversion is enzyme mediated function. Now around 10 to 20% of alcohol, it is metabolized by cytochrome P450 enzymes present in a microsomes, that is in the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. When the alcohol concentration in the blood increases, around 5% of the alcohol is lost from our body. Around 5% of the alcohol, so it will be going out of our body through lungs when we exhale, and also through the kidney, it is filtered into urine. Now let's see how alcohol is metabolized by enzyme mediated action in the liver. So we have ethanol here. So ethanol is converted to acetaldehyde. This is done by alcohol dehydrogenase enzyme. This particular enzyme, it is going to catalyze conversion of ethanol into acetaldehyde. This is a cytoplasmic enzyme. Alcohol dehydrogenase 1 is a cytoplasmic enzyme. It has got higher affinity for alcohol. It means it is going to metabolize alcohol into acetaldehyde. During this process, NAD is consumed and NADH+H+ is released in the cytoplasm. Now what will happen to the acetaldehyde? Largely acetaldehyde, it gets down into the mitochondria. So in the mitochondria, we have acetaldehyde dehydrogenase enzyme. So this acetaldehyde dehydrogenase enzyme, it is going to convert NAD into NADH+H+, and thereby take acetaldehyde into acetate. It is basically oxidizing acetaldehyde into acetate molecule. So there will be NADH+H+ produced in the mitochondria. Now acetaldehyde dehydrogenase, whenever it is saturated, because when person takes too much of alcohol, so ethanol converting into acetaldehyde further converted into acetate. So during this process, what happens, these enzymes can get saturated because they have their own Vmax. So whenever they reach their Vmax, so that means they won't be able to convert further much of alcohol into acetaldehyde and acetaldehyde into acetate. So during that time, what happens, there can be buildup of acetaldehyde, and this acetaldehyde, it can get out of the cytoplasm into blood. So acetaldehyde can get into blood, and in the blood it can enter into any tissues, especially when it enters into neurons, that is in the brain. So it is going to give rise to all the effects of alcohol. So the effects of alcohol, it is all because of the action of acetaldehyde on the central nervous system. And also acetaldehyde molecule, this is a toxic molecule. Acetaldehyde is toxic molecule. It is going to damage most of the biomolecules in our body. It can cause DNA adduct formation. It can damage proteins. So it is overall it's a toxic molecule. So the excess accumulation of acetaldehyde can be toxic to your liver cells. It can be toxic to all the other cells in our body. Okay. Now acetaldehyde converting into acetate, alcohol converting into acetaldehyde. So what happens, there will be elevated levels of NADH+H+ in the cytoplasm, and there will be elevated levels of NADH+H+ in the mitochondrial matrix. And that means there will be shortage of NAD+, because NAD+ are continuously consumed in alcohol metabolism, and you are making more and more NADH+H+. So that means NADH+H+, so our NAD ratio increases. So this lot of NADH+H+ in the mitochondria, in the cytoplasm, they will alter the metabolism of our cells. So that means there will be a alteration in the metabolism of the cells can lead to changes in the metabolic pathways, and that can give rise to certain consequences. Now, the toxic effects of alcohol, I have made a video. The link for that video is appearing right now in the right upper corner. You can watch that video to more about toxic effects of alcohol on our metabolic pathways, how they will change, lead to different signs and symptoms in our body. Okay, so this is how alcohol is metabolized. From ethanol is converted to acetaldehyde, acetaldehyde converted to acetate. Now, what happens to the acetate? Acetate, some of it is converted to acetyl-CoA in the liver by acetyl-CoA synthetase enzyme. Otherwise, liver is going to put this acetate into blood. It gets into the blood, and from the blood, peripheral tissues will take it. It will be taken up by the peripheral tissues, and in the peripheral tissue, it is converted into acetyl-CoA. And that job is done by acetyl-CoA synthetase enzyme. So this acetyl-CoA in the peripheral tissue and also in the liver, so it can be used for energy purpose. If the tissue needs energy, acetyl-CoA can go into TCA cycle. If the tissue do not need energy, so acetyl-CoA, it can go into fatty acid biosynthesis, fatty acid synthesis, and also it can go into cholesterol synthesis. That is why whenever person takes lot of alcohol, and if the person is a chronic alcoholic, so that means this buildup of acetyl-CoA can go into fatty acid synthesis. So imagine if this is going on in the liver, so it will give rise to fatty liver disorder or fatty steatosis. Cholesterol levels will also increase because acetyl-CoA can be converted to cholesterol. So this is how alcohol is ultimately converted to acetyl-CoA, and acetyl-CoA can give rise to fatty acid synthesis, thereby building triacylglycerol in the liver and the cholesterol synthesis there. Now, if there is a deficiency of acetaldehyde dehydrogenase enzyme, so you consider acetaldehyde dehydrogenase enzyme gene is mutated, and activity of acetaldehyde dehydrogenase, if it is decreased, that will lead to elevation of acetaldehyde, and that acetaldehyde can be toxic. It will give rise to nausea, it can give us to vomiting, and all the signs and symptoms of like toxic effects of alcohol can be seen in decreased activity of acetaldehyde. This can be seen in certain people, especially Chinese and Korean origin. So that is the disorder there is called as Asian flush syndrome. And Asian flush syndrome is because of toxic effects of acetaldehyde, and that's because of the decreased activity of acetaldehyde dehydrogenase. So, people of Chinese and Korean origin, so usually they will have genetic polymorphism where their alcohol dehydrogenase activity will be increased and acetaldehyde dehydrogenase activity will be decreased. Thereby, there will be buildup of acetaldehyde, and acetaldehyde will have a toxic effects. That means they will have blushing, flushing in their face. They will sense vomiting, nausea and vomiting. Basically, there will be distaste for alcohol in them. That is what is Asian flush syndrome. And also there is a drug called disulfiram. So the drug, right, disulfiram, it is going to inhibit acetaldehyde dehydrogenase enzyme. So acetaldehyde dehydrogenase enzyme is inhibited by this drug disulfiram. So that means whenever person alcoholic, he takes disulfiram, it is going to inhibit acetaldehyde dehydrogenase enzyme, thereby it increases acetaldehyde, and that acetaldehyde will have toxic effects, giving rise to flushing, giving rise to nausea and vomiting, and that will lead to development of distaste for alcohol. That's how disulfiram is going to decrease. Disulfiram is going to help alcoholic patients. Now let's move on to see how 10-20% of alcohol is metabolized in microsomal ethanol oxidizing system. So MEOS is microsomal ethanol oxidizing system, and one of the enzyme that is involved in this, mainly involved in metabolizing alcohol, is cytochrome P450-2E1. That is the enzyme which is responsible for oxidizing alcohol in the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Now, while this alcohol is metabolized, cytochrome P450 enzyme, there will be production of reactive oxygen species also. And these reactive oxygen species, they can damage DNA, they can damage proteins, overall they can damage our biomolecules. So, along with reactive oxygen species, we have acetaldehyde, which is toxic. So that is why together these two molecules, they can damage our biomolecules. There are a lot of toxic effects of alcohol on our metabolic pathways. And as I told you before, so you can watch my video on that. In the link for that is there in the description below, and also it is appearing right now in the upper right corner. Thanks again, and this is all about alcohol metabolism. I hope this video has helped you. If you have any questions, feel free to put that down in the comment section. I will answer to them as soon as possible. For regular updates from my channel, so you can consider subscribing to channel, and also click the bell button there where you can get a regular notification whenever I upload new videos. Thanks again, and see you in my next video.